Hello friends, welcome to the video lecture series on digital image processing. I am Dr. Dafda, and in this 39th video class of DIP, we will study Huffman coding. Huffman coding is used to remove coding redundancy. It is a lossless compression technique for image compression. In our 36th video class of DIP, we studied different types of redundancies, where we studied coding redundancy with one example. For that example, the method we used was Huffman coding, which we will study today in detail. So let us start. Huffman coding was derived by David Huffman in 1951, and hence the name Huffman coding is given to his technique. Huffman coding is a variable length encoding procedure where rather than using the 8-bit code, we use different length codes. And Huffman coding gives the smallest possible number of code symbols. It gives error-free or lossless compression as it is reversible. As we saw in the 36th video class, for Huffman coding, the length of the code should be inversely proportional to its probability of occurrence. That means the symbols that occur more often will have shorter code words. Also, the two symbols that occur least frequently will have the same length. These are the steps of Huffman coding. Number one, sort the symbols according to the decreasing order of their probabilities. Number two, combine the lowest probable symbols to form a composite symbol with probability equal to sum of respective probabilities. Now repeat step 2 until you are left with only two symbols or two intensity values. And finally, extract the code words from the resulting binary tree representation of the code. Let us understand with one example. Suppose we have a 8-bit image with 10 x 10 pixels. And say we have these symbols or intensity values RK, which is given, and probability that is also given. Now say frequency of occurrence of A2 is 40 times, so its probability will be 40 by 100, which is equal to 0.4, as total pixels are 10 cross 10. So this is already given in the question. The point to remember here is that you have to write the symbols in decreasing order of their probabilities. That means highest probability you have to write on the top, right? So here it is already arranged in the decreasing order. If not, you have to rearrange it. Now start with the last two values of probabilities and add them. So it is 0.06 plus 0.04, that will give you 0.1. Now write this 0.1 in the next column over here. So the other values we will write as it is: 0.4, 0.3, 0.1, 0.1, and these two will give us 0.1. But every time we do this, we have to maintain the next column also in the sorted manner, in the descending order, right? So 0.1 is already coming below all these values, right? So we'll write here itself. Next, add this 0.1 and 0.1, that will give you 0.2. So that 0.2 will go up in the order over here in the next column, and this 0.1 will come down after sorting, right? Other values will be as it is. Now add these two values, you will get 0.3. Add these two, that will give you 0.6. But as 0.6 is larger than 0.4, okay, 0.4 will come down and 0.6 will go up in the order. This procedure is called Huffman source reductions. Next procedure is Huffman code assignment. So we'll start from the right hand end of the table. We'll choose the maximum value, that is 0.6, and assign 0 to it, and we will assign 1 to 0.4. We can even assign the reverse, that is 1 to 0.6 and 0 to 0.4, and MATLAB follows this reverse nomenclature. So what will happen? Only the codes will be different, but still it will be uniquely decodable, right? Now we will go downwards and see from where this 0.6 came. So it came by adding these two. So we'll copy this 0 here. And now again we will append 0 to the first value and 1 to the second value. We will keep doing this downwards. This 0.3 came from this 0.2 and 0.1. For this 0.3, the value is 0,1. So we will write 0,1 and 0,1, and we will append 0 and 1. Similarly, this 0.2 came from this 0.1 and 0.1. So it is 0,1,0. So we will write here 0,1,0, 0,1,0, and we will add 0 and 1. And similarly, this 0.1 came from these two values. So value is 0,1,0,1. So we'll write 0,1,0,1 as it is, 0,1,0,1, and we will add 0 and 1. Now we got the codes for 0.06, which is 0,1,0,1,0, and 0.04, which is 0,1,0,1,1. So these two values are obtained. Now let's obtain the code for 0.4. So for this, we have to trace 0.4 going towards the right in the same row. So in the same row, we go ahead, and from here 0.4 went here, and it is having code 1. So we will write here 1. Similarly, for point 3, we go ahead here, again here, again here, and here we see that point 3 is 0, 0. So we will write here 0, 0. Now for point 1, it goes here, and from here it goes here. So here it is 0, 1, 1. So we will write here 0, 1, 1 for this point 1. For next 0.1, it goes here, and here we have denoted 0.1 as 0100. So we will write here 0100. So in this way, we obtain codes for A2 as 1, A6 as 00, A1 as 011, A4 as 0100, A3 as 01010, and A5 as 01011. So this is Huffman encoding. Now say the encoded string is which is sent as the message. Now the question comes, how to decode this string? For decoding this string, read the symbol from the left one at a time and search whether it exists or not. If it exists, write the symbol for it. If not, take two symbols and continue like this. So is 0 present in the code? No. So take 01. 01 is not present. So again no. So take 010. 010 again doesn't exist. So take 0101. 0101 again no. Take 01010. 01010. Yes, it is for A3, right? So 01010 is for A3. Now from remaining, take 0. 0 exists. No. Take 01. 01 exists. Again no. 011. 011. Yes, it is for A1. So 011 is for A1. Now 1 exists. Yes, it is for A2. Right. So this one is for A2. Again 1. Yes, A2. Now 0. No, 0 doesn't exist. And 00. Yes, 00 is present for A6. So this 00 is for A6. So in this way, we obtain the decoded string as A3, A1, A2, A2, A6. Right? So this is how we decode the Huffman code at the receiving end. Now, as we did in our 36th video class, let us calculate L average. Next is entropy. We know that entropy is minus sum of probability into log base 2 of probability. The entropy or average information of an image is a measure of the degree of randomness in the image. More the entropy means more the randomness or more the uncertainty, and thus more information is present. See, it is a lower limit for the average coding length in bits per pixel, which can be realized by an optimal coding scheme without any loss of information. Okay. Also, we can find the efficiency of Huffman code to analyze how effective our code is. So, efficiency is given by entropy divided by L average. Thus, the efficiency is 97.43%, which is very good efficiency. Next is compression ratio. Compression ratio is 3.63. And finally, redundancy, which comes out to be 72.46%. The written explanation is shown in these slides. Now, next question that comes in mind is that can't we assign random codes still lower in size than Huffman codes? The answer to this question is that in that case, it will not be a uniquely decodable code. While Huffman code is lossless or error-free and still uniquely decodable code. Okay, let us implement the Huffman coding and decoding of an image in MATLAB. We are reading an image cameraman.tiff and resizing it to 4x4 pixels, that is 16 values, so that we can understand the method easily. We plot this resized image in one of the subplot after converting it from double having value 0 to 1 to uint 8 or 8-bit image having value 0 to 255. Using this line, we find the size of the image and store the number of rows and columns into mn. So the total count will be equal to 16. Using this line, we find all the unique intensity values that are present in the image. This line counts the number of times the symbols have occurred, and now this line calculates the probability of the symbols. This line creates Huffman dictionary having all the intensity values with its Huffman code. Also, we find the L average. This line calculates the entropy, that is degree of randomness in the image, and using this line, we calculate the efficiency of the Huffman code. Using this equation, we calculate the compression ratio, and this line finds the redundancy in percentage. Now, to perform encoding using Huffman code, we convert the symbols from 2-dimension to 1-dimension using the reshape command of this line. This line performs Huffman encoding by using 1D symbols and Huffman dictionary. Similarly, this line performs decoding at the receiving end. This line restores the image to 2D image of 4x4 pixels. And finally, using this line, we restore the image by plotting the transpose of the matrix in the second subplot. So let us run the program and see the output. So this is our original cameraman image, which we have resized to 4x4 pixels. And this is the decoded image, which is the same as the original image. Now in the command window, we can see different values. So these are the pixel values of 4x4 cameraman image. The unique symbols are displayed next. So here the repeating symbols will not be shown. For example, 126 is occurring 2 times. So the number of unique symbols are 14. The probabilities of occurrence of these unique symbols are displayed next. The average length of the code is 3.75 for this example, and entropy is also 3.75 for this example. That means that the code is 100% efficient, right? So efficiency is 100%. Compression ratio comes out to be 2.133, and relative data redundancy is 53.12%. That means 53.12% data is redundant. So the Huffman encoded code is shown here for the pixel values 16x16, right? And you can see that code in the dictionary, right? So if we see the dictionary, these are the different code words that are assigned to different intensity values. So 126 and 160 are occurring more number of times, and therefore the code is short. And in the encoded code, you can see that the values are 169, 157, 167, right? So 169 is having code 1010, 157 is 1000, and 167 is 1011. Okay, so in the encoded message, we will see 1010, 1000, and 1011. You can see here 1010, 1000, and 1011. Similarly, other codes are also assigned, and the Huffman decoding will be recovering the original pixels. 169, 157 and 167 are the first three symbols. So here you can see that the Huffman code is having the length of 60, and our original image was having length 4x4x8 bit, right? So 4x4x8 will be 128 divided by 60, which is equal to 2.133. So the compression ratio that we are achieving here is 2.133. So if, for example, the image is of 2 MB, then we need to send only 1 MB. We are compressing it to 1 MB, and this is known as compression. The MATLAB code developed for the lecture is present in the description box. Also, the Hindi version of this lecture is present in the Hindi playlist of digital image processing. So that is all for this video class. I hope you would have gained a good knowledge from this video lecture. Thank you very much.